for all your photo, video, and voiceover needs, check out the fine folks at Blu Ray Productions. They will take good care of you. If you don't believe me, you can see for yourself. Check out their work at blueberryproductions.tv, the Facebook page, Blueberry Productions, also a Vimeo page, a YouTube page, and it's Blueberry, BLUBERRY, prod on Twitter. Check them out today. Blueberry Productions, great people, great work, great service.
Hey there, your yard took a real beating this summer. Luckily, Scott's Turf Builder Winter Guard has your back. Just feed your grass with Scott's again this fall when the air is cool and the soil is warm. It's the perfect time to give your lawn a boost. If you do, Winter Guard will give your yard the nourishment it needs to help weak, thin grass recover and support root growth, giving you a greener, more resilient lawn both now and next spring. Guaranteed. Grab a bag of Scott's Turf Builder Winter Guard today. You'll be back to barbecuing in no time. This is a Scott's Yard.
Hey parents, we all try to be extra careful with our children in the car, but then we get an important call or text. Remember, our children are watching. Make every drive a good example. Be in the zone. Turn off your phone. Visit childrenshospital.vanderbilt.org/BITZ to learn more about our Teen Driver Safety Program. Brought to you by Monroe Carroll Jr. Children's Hospital at Vanderbilt, the Ford Motor Company Fund, and the Allstate Foundation.
Hello, my name is Travis Williams, President and CEO of Academics and Athletic Consulting, focusing on educating and empowering tomorrow's collegiate athletic leaders. My passion is for the education and genuine concern and care for today's student athlete. It's the centerpiece of my life's work. A college education, both in and out of the classroom, is a truly rewarding benefit. For more information on AAC, you can go to www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Once again, www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Or you can follow me on Facebook at Academics and Athletic Consulting, or Twitter at Coach TWill24, or Instagram Travis L. Williams 24. Or you can call me at 404-542-607. Once again, AAC is very proud to partner with J.R. McHenry of the Boss Man Radio Show, covering sports and entertainment across the country. Please tune in weekly for informative, entertaining, and expert analysis on today's sports and entertainment topics. Thank you.
Folks, you asked for it. We're doing it for you. Quarantine special. So we got 2 hours for you. First hour would be material. Hour two, all your emails. 2 hours of fun. Quarantine style. Now I'll turn over to the man himself. Rizzo the Four Horseman. Rizzo Boss Man Show member. My radio tag team partner. My main man. The one only, Hollywood Alec. What's good, brother?
Yo, 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 and we're back on this quarantine time with the show just for you, because we know you're in the house, we know you're probably bored, we know you're probably not doing anything but sitting around eating and looking like a bunch of booger wolves just like us, you know what I'm saying, because we can't go out and get no haircut or nothing like that, you know, women are tripping out because they can't go and get their hair done or they can't go and get their nails or toes done, so they're walking around with claws, you know, but it's all good, because we're here to save you. We're here to help you through this difficult time, brother. We're here to make sure that you enjoy yourself in this time where everybody's being quarantined, and people are, of course, breaking quarantine, and me and Boss are just talking about how people are having crab boils and crawfish boils and big all-time social gatherings, block parties, you name it. You understand? But see, me, you know, I don't like to be sick in the first place. So I got my ass in the house.
Correct.
You understand? Because to me, that's the safest place to be. Everything I need is right here. You understand? Everything I need. So, therefore, you know, if I need to go to the store, I'm going to go to the store. If I need to go put some gas or do something to get something to eat, I'm going to do that. But you know what? I'm going to bring my ass right back home.
Correct.
You understand? There's something that people don't understand. It's almost as if it's like people are like children. You know what I'm saying? Like, especially right now in this time, it's like dealing with a bunch of kids. You know, you keep telling a kid no, they're going to want to go and do everything that you told them not to do in the first place.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? It's like the more you tell them not to do it, the more they want to do it. You know? So it just pays sometimes to listen, you know what I'm saying, and be careful and take the precautions, you know what I'm saying? Because, I mean, whether you know it or not, it doesn't even matter. All I hear right now is coronavirus. It's almost like it's a trend.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? It's almost like it's a big trend. And all you hear, you don't hear shit. Man, look, you don't hear nothing about AIDS.
Nah. None.
Zero. You don't hear anything anymore about cancer. You don't hear anything anymore about, you know, 24-hour walking Ebola. It doesn't even matter. You don't hear nothing about it no more. The only thing you hear about is coronavirus. And everything is coronavirus. And it's just out of hand. Everything?
Everything.
Everything right now is coronavirus. You know, if you sneeze hard enough and your nose starts bleeding and you go to the doctor and say, look, man, I sneeze and my nose starts bleeding, I promise you, they're going to diagnose you with corona.
Correct.
Even though you don't have corona. As a matter of fact, a friend of mine had to go to the doctor to get a second opinion because he said, man, how do you test positive for COVID, but you have no symptoms? I said, well, bro, I mean, can you smell and taste? Yes. I just got finished eating the steak. I said, you ain't got no fever. Well, no. Well, you need to go and get a second opinion. So he went to the doctor, got a second opinion, and he had no COVID whatsoever. When at first he tested positive for COVID. So yes, ladies and gentlemen, something stinks. You understand? But I'm not going to get into all that. The thing is you need to stay safe wherever you are. Make sure if you need to wear a mask, wear a mask. If you don't want to wear a mask, that's you. You know, when you're in the store, wherever you're going, wear gloves. If you don't want to wear gloves, that's you. You understand? We just want to make sure that you're being safe. Because your FUIs, you don't know no better.
Correct.
All right. Woo! Now, we got a whole bunch of material. Well, looky here, looky
a
here.
A lot of material. More than usual material.
I mean, this is preposterous if you ask me. But, you know, we just can't keep you all sitting around waiting. I mean, after all, decided to do that show. We're, you know, we're back tonight after popular demand, you know, because you're bored, you know what I mean, being at home in quarantine. And I know if you all are asking for a show, you know what I'm saying, you're hella bored.
Correct.
That's a shame. Is it a surprise? No. Is it a shame? Absolutely. Now, I was informed by the boss that we have some celebrities in the house.
Yes, we do. Both of them are here.
Yeah, they shall remain unnamed. But well, you know what? We're going to let you know. We know you're there. We're sending you a shout out.
Correct.
All right? All right, man, what's up? You want to get into this material?
Yes, let's hit this audio material, these FUIs that has happened over this past 2 months of COVID fever we've been going through right now.
I mean, it's a lot. It's a lot. All right, let me start right here. Trina succinctly shut down curmudgeonous. That's a hell of a word. Curmudgeonous Caius hope for an Instagram battle. Biscayne Boulevard bickering ensues. I'm not surprised.
Not at all. Not those two.
I'm not surprised. I mean, I think if Tina actually tries to get into some type of battle with Kaya, to me, and honestly, you know, that's like going from filet mignon to soybean burger.
Correct.
You know what I mean? Like, this is the same chick that I forget that what show that was with MC Search looking for the next female rap star, and like she bit her own lyric to battle a chick, like, and Search was livid, like, dude, like, what are you doing? And I think she could have been a force to be reckoned with, but she was too busy pulling shenanigans.
Yes, indeed, like, for real.
Yeah, so
one hit wonder,
I don't
Kaya.
Know. Huh?
One hit wonder, Kaya. She had one song.
Yes. One hit wonder. Like, and for her to have a platinum record and be on a show like that, it was almost like a slap in the face in the first place. Like, that was a show for like so called rookies, like people just trying to get a deal. You know, and you done fell off that much that you're actually on that show and then got booted off the show. So it is in my humble opinion that she might be more encapsulated in drama than her own music.
I'd agree with that.
That's pretty exciting. I just don't know about that. But anyway, we don't want to give her too much promotion. So we're gonna go to the next one, okay?
Most definitely.
Hold it down. Beelzebubish, victim blaming, bottom shelf white woman Betsy DeVos changes rules for campus sexual assault. Accused rapist allowed to cross examine accused.
Wow.
Really? Accused rapist allowed to cross-examine accusers. I don't even know what to say about that. I mean, if they have the evidence, you're guilty. Or maybe it's a setup. I mean, they could get up there and start cross-examining and then, you know, I mean, first of all, there's no rape victim or sexual assault victim, you know, worth their weight that actually wants to see the accused.
Most definitely.
Let alone having that person talk to them. So I don't know about that. That's a shenanigan waiting to happen.
Yep.
All right.
Competent Trump administration at its finest. Incompetent Trump
Of course. It doesn't get any worse. But, you know. Here we go. Big Meech. Free the infamous Black Mafia family leader wants out early due to COVID-19 running rampant through the federal prison system. I think they're going to let him die up in there. They'd rather get Tekashi out.
Most definitely.
You know, Tekashi, you know, Meech didn't drop no dime, as far as I know. But they'll let Tekashi out. Because Tekashi put 100 brothers under the jail. they still got people going to prison for what he was telling.
Yeah, he gonna get gapped it's, somewhere somehow.
Well, I mean,
he won't live very long.
No, I mean it's pretty disappointing if you ask me. The appropriation is disappointing. You know what I'm saying? Because you got a whole community and culture of people who say that snitching is wrong. You understand? I know cats whose careers were diminished because somebody accused them of snitching. But this guy snitched, and now he's getting celebrated. Like, where do they do that at? And then the cultural appropriation is ridiculous. Like, he's going to be the next Elvis. Like, this cat is making history, and he snitched. What are we doing? It's ridiculous. Like, it's stupid. Okay? All right, what is this? Bigot behind the scenes. Black blue blood staffer accuses white costume designer. And that was spelled with triple K's. Of racial discrimination. That little black girl is a hot ghetto mess. Well, whether she was or wasn't, it's not up to you to call. Some things you just have to keep to yourself unless you want to get your ass kicked. Or unless you want to get put on blast. See, my thing is that we, as a community, we don't worry about too many other communities. We just want to be amongst ourselves and have people mind their own business. What's within our community, we'll fix within our community just like everybody else. You understand? But, I mean, to label her, you know, then say the little black girl is a hot ghetto mess, it just...
So low.
It reeks of your bigotry.
Huh? So loaded with bigotry and racism and just everything.
Oh, God, yeah, from start to finish. Like, seriously? Oh, God, man, here we go. Get your lives together. Peter Guns and Life Jennings have a messy exchange of words over Amina Butterfly on Instagram. Oh, God, where do I begin with this, bro? First of all, Peter Guns is a dirtbag American. Like, he's a scumbucket. Like, for real. And he's everything that's wrong or everything that's stereotypically wrong or how other people see us when it comes to our own women. Like, and I don't know if you watched the show or anything, but he was just a dirtbag, you know what I'm saying, to these women. You know what I'm saying? And then you got enough nerve, you know, to be at your baby mama's apartment on the couch, strumming a guitar with a dirty beat up white beater, some blue shorts and some dirty feet.
Wow.
Like, for real? And what's even worse than that is these are the women that picked them. Like, clearly lowering themselves. Like, it's ridiculous, dude. You wrote one hit.
Deja Vu, right?
One hit.
With Deja Vu, right? With Lord Tariq,
yes.
Right?
Yes. One hit. That's it. And that was many a moon ago. That was like in 96?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I figured. Unfreaking believable. And they're lowering their standard because you're pretty much a hip-hop laughing stock. You know what I'm saying? Trying to make $15 off of that, off of the notoriety of that record. It's just ridiculous. Like, you're bumming. You're like one... You're one step away from vagrancy. And this is how you're treating this chick that you married. Anyway. The Lincoln Project, led by George Conway, the husband of Kellyanne Conway, slams Trump's handling of the coronavirus pandemic in a new scathing ad. And I would love to see that ad.
It's pretty bad.
Because, yeah, I figure, because I don't know what the bloody hell, and I'm not trying to bash anybody, you know what I'm saying? I understand he's president, whatever. But it almost seems as if, to the president, it almost seems like in his mind, this thing is comical. It's like he still don't take it serious.
He don't.
You know. We have a, pretty much we have a court jester for a president. So, you know, I don't give a damn how much money he has, but. Okay. Now, we're going to my city that I lived in for about a good 12 years. All right. A Dallas salon owner who defied state and country orders and reopened her business was sentenced to a week in jail and was fined at least $3,500. And I hope she sues the crap out of everybody involved. You know, people have to live, of course, man. I mean, what's the difference? You know, you got people going in the store. If people want to go inside of her business, that's their prerogative. That does not necessarily or automatically equate to coronavirus is going to be spread that way if she's doing it the way she's supposed to be doing it. What?
Yeah.
Woman killed by gator in South Carolina.
Yes.
Was doing homeowner's nails.
The gator broke through the door. The door was actually open for air, and the gator came in the house.
That's serious. Getting your nails done and you get burnt by a gator. I mean, that's rough.
Well, maybe that was her karma for them making a house call during the pandemic. Just saying.
Right.
Yeah, let's go make a house call and yeah, you got called home, all right.
Oh my god.
Well, definitely a home going, wasn't it?
Oh my god. I just choked. That was funny. You got called home, all right. Right. All right. A man delivers a flying foot fade during girl fight at Cumberland Mall, and Twitter is astonished. Unbelievable.
Yeah, I might hit him now. It sure did.
Right. Okay, Cumberland Mall in Atlanta is trending after video surfaces of three girls fighting, with security guards dragged to the ground and a man drop kicking one of the women and shoving the guard. They must have been, I wonder if it was like one of those Rock and Roll Express drop kicks.
No, it was more like a Power Rangers or a Mortal Kombat kick. Finish him!
That fool did a savant kick. How you do a Booker T kick, like?
Exactly. Oh my
god. Man, that is crazy. Okay, our astronaut angst. Oh jeez. Future claims his alleged baby mama Eliza Rain turned his world upside down. I don't think Future gets it.
Yeah, I know, so we don't get rubbers.
He just doesn't. He doesn't believe. No, we were going there as raw dog and hope and pray for the best.
Exactly. Like, my man, that's not how it works.
Right. And then you have a gall to be in shock. You understand? Because you're having drama. Maybe the problem is you. You know? Anyway, go to school. All right. Rudy Gobert responds to Twitch troll who thanked them for spreading COVID-19 in the NBA.
Damn, that's petty.
That's real petty. He must be really bored. I think I'm going to respond to this one dude on Twitch. Just one guy. Okay, now we're about to go there. All right. Minimal Bars icon French Montana claims his music can beat anyone except Drake and Jay-Z.
Wow, French.
All right. I want y'all to understand, and when I say minimal bars, that is not by any stretch of the imagination an exaggeration. Like, seriously. Like, those bars are borderline romper room with a hand at the end. Goo goo, boo boo, woo woo, and hand. Like my son can rap better than that. But anyway, you know, not tripping.
I ain't worried about nothing.
All right. Unbelievable. Okay. Nice try. Portia Williams destroys Dennis McKinley's postpartum caused cheating claims he was selfish. You don't say. Postpartum caused cheating. First of all, if you're going to pull a shenanigan, dude, you're going to have to come up with a better lie. That's number one. You know, if not, then, you know, hey, there it is. Next, lawyered up. Oh, jeez. This dude. Scott Disick says he's not suffering from substance abuse. Reportedly plans to sue rehab facility over leaked photo. Yeah, I mean, he would. I figure that he would be trying to capitalize, you know, off of something. Trying to get a little money. Yeah, you know, I ain't hating on you, bro. Do you? Anyway. Skirt! Police catch 5-year-old Utah boy driving to California to cop himself a Lamborghini.
Wow. Privileged.
That is unbelievable. Literally. Like, 5-year-old Utah boy driving to California to cop himself a Lamborghini. All right. Now, here's some serious stuff right here, bro. Whose lives matter? COVID incubating soup cookies. What? Say that again. COVID incubating soup cookies in Sacramento sparked Caucasian chaos at Capitol protesting police and policies. Karens and Cody's carried to the clink.
Wow.
Now that was funny. That was funny. Karen's and Cody.
Karen's and Cody's.
Carry to the clink. All right. COVID incubating soup cookies. All right. Shit is real. Kansas City Chiefs Super Bowl balling halfback Damian Williams robbed for $1,000 inside swanky Los Angeles Airbnb.
Hey, look,
I'm not surprised.
He was on Instagram flexing and somebody came up there and got him. Caddy's location.
Oh, okay.
Deed to himself.
I'm sure. I'm sure. You know, you want to be on TV balling and shot calling, brother, I promise you, somebody's going to come see you. You know? Because, no, I mean, where was it? At a Los Angeles Airbnb?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're not the only person that has been there. All they needed is one tip, or it could have been inside job. You never know. Okay. Oh, God. Corona Cruise. Carnival Cruise that sets sail again. Just 1 week after no sail order expired.
Waiting to die.
Pretty
get
much.
On a ship, and you're going to die.
And the funny part is, you know, a couple of miles away from where I go take runs at, like during the weekend in Fouchon, Louisiana, one of these cruise ships had actually docked near a place called Morgan City. And Morgan City is a relatively small town. And you're going to dock this big ass cruise liner in these little rivers in Morgan City with all their salmonella victims on the cruise line. Thinking that they're all going to be just quarantined in one spot and not lose their minds too. It was crazy. I mean, to see it is crazy. Unbelievable. And they're going out again. Oh, I heard about this. Maybach messiness. Rick Ross, pregnant baby mama Brianna Camille, sues rich forever father for paternity and child support. And you want to know what the funny part is? This has not been the first time.
You know,
you would hate to say that this guy whose brand of rap is now called excuse me, luxury rap, you know, doesn't want to step up to the plate, as Montel Williams would say, and take care of his kitty. You know, I don't understand what's going on with that. You?
Man, dude just got a big head right now and moved on to a new chick now, leaving her in the dust pretty much, saying you deal with it and we'll fight it out in court. Kind of a savage kind of mindset.
That's crazy. Like that's some cash money shit. See you in court.
Mm-hmm.
Don't give a damn who you is. See you in court. Okay. Gabrielle Union says marginalized celebs are struggling during COVID-19 crisis. Critics cry foul. You're rich.
Got that right.
You tell me how you're struggling.
From your mansion.
Any crisis. How are you struggling? What? What are you struggling for? And what do you think you're struggling for? That's what I ought to say. It's not like you're really struggling. What do you think you're struggling for? We'll wait. No, we won't.
No, we won't.
All right, give us a break. Damn. Deadly murder hornets loaded with venom arrive in the United States. Murder hornet. And first, we thought the Jack and Jills were about the worst thing on earth. And now, we've got murder hornets. And I've seen, like, I saw a little picture of these murder hornets, like, maybe 3 years ago. And those things are huge. Now, I don't know if this is something that we should be worried about, but it's just another to add to the fear factor in being able to easily control us. Because, you know, a person who's scared is easier to manipulate than a person who isn't. So, man. But anyway, Lord have mercy, where are we at? Delusional dunce. Donald Trump retweets claim he's done more for blacks than all other presidents combined. Okay. Well, even that, I mean, let's say that that were true. Okay? So now all you're saying is basically you've done five things for blacks. That was basically hand out hamburgers or a bucket of chicken. So you basically done nothing. You understand? Because I don't know of any presidents that have really, really done anything for black people. Oh, Lord, help me.
Yeah.
I can't leave, baby. Now R. Kelly thinks he's diabetic. Still trying to get out of here. Well, he's really putting it on now. It's going to be another episode of In the Closet. Except it's going to be in the jailhouse. And now he's trying to pull out all the stops to get out of prison.
All the stops.
Dude, they're gonna let him rot. Unbelievable. No ish, Sherlock. Scott Disick, once again, believes Tristan Thompson has been dribbling Chloe K's double stuff dunk-a-dunk. All quarantine.
Tristan Thompson's back in the news. Oh my God.
He's the worst. I don't understand. Like, oh, you know, probably has. Maybe. Right, here's a good one right here. All right, let me see. Swirl gone south. Stacey Dash and fourth hubby divorcing following domestic dispute debacle. Okay, now let me get this straight. You've had four husbands. And they have all apparently been pushed to the curb. And you don't think the problem is you. Not one iota. You know. I remember when Stacey Dash, she used to be the stuff that little teenager wet dreams were made of.
Mm-hmm.
Back when we were coming up. And now all I see her basically doing is jacking herself up in the public eye. It's time for her to have a seat and reevaluate herself. Maybe she will, maybe she won't. Okay. So it is what it is. It happens. Ching Mi finally admits hooking up with Tiffany Haddish after calling her a liar and denying it. Dude, really? this is crazy. She first of all, what in the hell is Chingy still doing?
Yeah, what is he still doing? I don't know why he's interrupting right now.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, like, what is he doing? Is he working in a factory? Is he, like, building houses, doing carpentry or something like that? You know, I don't know. I don't know. It's Chingy, of all people. Quarantine confession. Gabrielle Union says she once subtly told Steph and Aisha Curry to break up and sleep around.
Wow.
You really think she did that?
Yeah, I believe she did. I put nothing past the FUI Gabrielle Union, okay?
Never.
She's an FUI. Never. She's up there.
Oh, God, yeah. Like, I'm not going to put her in my top 10.
Dwayne Wade's the FUI,
she's
too.
Fuck.
Just so people know.
Oh, dude. Very much so.
His attire is
like,
very FUI.
Don't let him.
I'll leave you at that.
I mean, concerning D Wade, you just can't let. You know, you can't let the shenanigans fool you. Okay, let me see. Oh, hell no. Atlanta Mayor Keisha Bottoms' 12-year-old son also received racist N-word text, state attorney general investigating. 12-year-old son. So it was a text, a racist text that went out.
Because she wants to keep
some goon
she,
or
she wants to keep Atlanta closed, and the governor doesn't. Which, you know, her son got sent a horrible text because his mama wants to keep people alive and not put them in caskets, like Brian Kemp, the purge Kemp.
Right. I don't know. Okay. Hate it or love it. Downtrodden dunker. Aaron Gordon drops disgruntled diss towards D. toward Demeritorious Dwayne Wade over dunk contest denial. Air ball bars abound. Really? Dude, that one segment right there, that sounded like a whole rap all with
you. Exactly.
You would have figured it was being freestyle. Okay. Pandemic pilfering. Craft caretaker steals $13,000 engagement ring from woman dying of coronavirus. And she was swiftly sent to jail. All right.
Daddy.
She was swiftly sent to jail. Okay. Make America gas lit again. Really? 53% of white women's President Donald Trump says he was being sarcastic in suggesting we inject COVID-19 patients with poisonous disinfectant.
No, he meant that.
Yeah, I think he meant it too. And was saying it, but on the cool. You know what I'm saying? Some B. And how stupid, like, you say it and don't even put it in the context, you know, that it was a joke.
Exactly.
If you were joking. All right. Scammy shenanigans. Jeweler says Javante Davis tried to pay for $250,000 worth of bling with a fake check and filed suit. Well, brother, here's another knucklehead trying to ball out of control. You understand? And try to floss his little money or whatever. It's stupid. With a fake check.
Wow.
As if the check is not going to get checked. Like, after all, how did they find him out? Like, who was alerted?
What an idiot.
Dude. Let me see. Clamoring COVID. Clamoring COVIDian.
The governor of Georgia. First pimp, Brian Kemp.
Dude, I was speechless. He called him a COVIDian. To reopen Georgia's barbershops, bowling alleys, and coronavirus-coded establishments Friday.
The death trap. The purge, the genocide of blacks. The death trap. Places we all go to.
Oh, what? Basically, you know, and of course my wife's going to have herself at the store. You know. All right. Crazy.
Wow, that next one's already got me laughing.
Dude, I had to read it like twice. Okay. Now look at you. Fat gargling. Oh my God. Fat gargling Georgia governor. Brian Kemp. Chuck and jive just for his zaddy Donald Trump to throw him under a barter bus.
Oh my goodness.
Dude, that's pitiful. Fat gargling Georgia governor.
I can't get through with my left hip. They're like, damn.
Dude, it was funny. That was funny. Unbelievable. Defamation denied. Oh, really? Judge says future alleged baby mama Eliza Rain won't have to pay over mass innocent slander. Ah! I'm gonna have to find out more details on that. Keisha Knight Pulliam wants ex-hubby Ed Hartwell jailed for allegedly owing $32,000 in court-ordered child support. Man, what's going on? Mm-hmm. Nobody wants to take care of their children.
I was not.
You know, you wouldn't. I'm sure he wasn't playing that role when he was up in Rudy's gut. You know, take care of your kids, man. Or do something. I mean, of course, we don't know the whole story, but still. All right. Here we go. COVIDiot quote of the day. There are more important things than living. Thirsty Texas Trump-sucking Lieutenant Governor Dan Patrick. Okay. This idiot said, COVIDiot, there are more important things than living?
Wow.
What?
What a goofball.
I mean, tell me, what? I mean, you can't do anything if you're dead. So, tell me, what more important, I mean, tell me, give me these more important things that are more important than living.
Correct.
I don't understand. I don't understand. Okay. Teddy Scam. Are in Beijing legend. That was classic. R in Beijing legend Teddy Riley struggles with modern technology during versus battle against Babyface, gets clowned into the brunch fedora and biz.
Wow.
That R in Beijing, that was funny. Did you actually see the battle?
I couldn't stop laughing at that crap. Especially the first one, he put his hand on his hip and the fedora, and he had that meme. That was the funniest crap ever. He's firing everybody, and he had that background sound of the dude that was just dancing, this hype man. Like, for real.
That is ridiculous.
That was above everyone's FBI behavior right ridiculous. There. Very much so.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm talking about brunch fedora. All right. Kenneth. Babyface Edmund. Living legend work wife. Yeah, that's for real. Tony Braxton befuddled by Teddy Riley's uncle encrusted heir. Live tweet. Theodore Turmoil.
She did do that.
Theodore. Yeah, but man, dude, like Babyface and Tony, like that's forever. All right,
we got 5 minutes to go before we take a break and go and get the emails. We got 5 minutes, people. We'll start emails at the top of the hour. We got 5 minutes to go.
Man, how are you all liking this freaking this doggone this FUI
They're
news?
Going crazy. I can't keep with the comments.
It's something else. Like it's something else. This is insane. Social and you know dip. Yeah. Stupid MF in Florida. Rush to the beach after Trump's sucking governor deems it essential.
Idiot.
How is the beach essential?
Essential to your ass dying. It's essential to that if you want to die.
Pretty much.
Put you in a casket. Make the morticians richer.
What? That's it. You know, they taking all of it. And leaving you emotional. But I don't understand that, man. I think it's too damn early, you know, and just like I was telling my wife, but I'm keeping it just the way it is. This is the way it was before this stuff started, and I don't have a problem with not breaking the monotony this time. I just don't. So, okay. Bye, bigot. Two students get expelled from Georgia High School after posting racist TikTok using the N-word. Now, I know everybody saw it. You know, you have to be... Then she tried to throw him under the bus. The chick. Like, you all... They're, you know, doing their little stupid video that they knew they were going to get backlash from. She starts getting scared and throws him under the bus. And that she did. All right. Does he have a point? Tory Lanez thinks there's a lot of similarities between him and Ty. Yeah, this dude is overstepping his boundaries right now, brother. I mean, what are you thinking? You know, Pac was a real revolutionary and OG. These kids don't have a clue. And the fact that he even said that just shows what type of F.U. out this guy is. All right. Church clown came back to bite. Louisiana attorney representing Reverend Devesley defying social... I remember that. Yeah. Devesley defying social distancing diagnosed with COVID-19. Well, it has been said that you shouldn't tempt God.
Exactly.
So you know how that goes. Cognac.
That'll be our last one.
Kenyan governor.
Last one before we go to the emails.
All right. Kenyan governor Mike Sonko blasted for including Hennessy in coronavirus.
Did Swish help him come up with that plan?
Dude. Did he pass out blunts? We're going to make these blunts part of the plan. That's a good plan. Ain't nobody going to remember the night after. Everybody going to be toe up. All right. How much time we got?
We are right here at the limit here. So, folks, that was hour one material. Hour two up next, your favorite. Emails. Boston Hollywood, quarantine special. Back in five. Out.
We out.
Hip hop fans, I got a great album for you. The debut album from Family Grind ENT, True Speech and 313 Fresh. We're going to give you two discs, 33 songs of pure, genuine hip hop. Albums available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, illstreetrex.com. And streaming live right now on Rhapsody, Beats Music, Spotify, Xbox Music, Slacker Radio, and SoundCloud. Check them out today. True Speech and 313 Fresh, Family Grind, ENT. Believe in it. Get it.
A gorgeous tan from Suntan City gives you an inner glow that relights the fire when you run into your first crush.
Vicky, who was that?
An old boyfriend.
Lucky you just tanned at Suntan City.
Lucky he's single. We're doing lunch tomorrow.
Won't be single for long then.
During Tour of the City, try all 5 tans, including spray tan, for just $4.99. Restrictions may apply. Click to buy now.
When you're a teen, you finally get to make some of your own decisions. Who are you going to hang out with? What do you want to be? Are you going to glance at that text while driving? Remember, a split second is all it takes for something tragic to happen. Be in the zone. Turn off your phone. Visit childrenshospital.vanderbilt.org/BITZ to learn more about our Teen Driver Safety Program. Brought to you by Monroe Carroll Jr. Children's Hospital at Vanderbilt, the Ford Motor Company Fund, and the Allstate Foundation.
It's maybe the night that my dreams might let me know. All the stars are closer. All the stars are closer.
Tell me what you're gonna do to me. Confrontation ain't nothing new to me. You could bring a bullet, bring a sword, bring a morgue, but you can't bring the truth to me.
Alexa, play Kendrick Lamar and SZA.
Okay.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
Yeah, yeah, it's your man JC, the host with the most, baby, and it goes down each and every Saturday night right here in the city of Memphis. That's right, y'all. It goes down at Clicks Sports Bar Memphis, baby, 3705 Malco Way, Memphis, Tennessee, 38125. Come out and join us, the Three Kings, each and every Saturday night for the livest karaoke in the city. Everybody gets in free till 10 p.m., only $5 after. Great food. We got drink specials. We got all kind of games, man. We got the pool tables popping. Whatever you want, we got you, man. Come on out. Have a good time with us each and every Saturday night. That's Clicks Sports Bar, Memphis. We'll be right back.
time skipping the beat. You're not close enough, so that space between you and me, let's lose it. The way you're dancing, swaying to the music, girl, that body and how you move it. Every time you cross my mind, girl, I lose it.
Alexa, play the Country Heat playlist.
Okay.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
It's maybe the night that my dreams might let me know. All the stars are closer. All the stars are closer.
Tell me what you gonna do to me. Confrontation ain't nothing new to me. You could bring a bullet, bring a sword, bring a morgue, but you can't bring the truth to me.
Alexa, play Kendrick Lamar and SZA.
Okay.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
Till the tears run down from my eyes, Lord, somebody, ooh, somebody, can anybody find me somebody to love?
Alexa, play hits from Queen.
Okay.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
Special FUI report, Boston Hollywood. You've been clamoring for this segment. I've got Hollywood. I have in my email inbox from FUIs 1,713 emails. I've given you the best 12 so far. If we have time, I will give you more. But before we get started, I'll turn over to the man himself, Hollywood Alex, to tell our new listeners. Or FUIs, what happens during this segment? Well, to expect for the next 55 minutes of quality email material from you, the FUI submissions to the Boss Man Show website. Let us know what it is. Hollywood, talk to the people, man.
Oh my God. These emails are ridiculous. And I'm sure that every FUI out there will enjoy them, because that's what you do. Oh gosh. Okay. We're getting into the listener emails on this edition of our quarantine session. Well, all you FUIs are sitting in your house waiting for us to begin. So here it goes. Nothing. All right. Dude, I hope you're ready for this one.
I'm seeing it. Oh God, it's terrible.
Tangerine in bold cube. Thanks again to my schedule today and tomorrow morning at work. And then I'll let you guys know how much we appreciate the opportunity for us. Thanks again for your support and hope you're having fun with your team today. And I will do it again soon as I get back out there at my office and get back in the morning. And let you know what time I'll be there. Okay. I'll let you talk with him later. Thanks. Love you guys. Hope you're doing well. I'll call again soon. Thanks for everything. And let me know if I can come up to you. And let me see what it looks like. It's the morning day, beautiful day. So I'm glad you're going to come back and get your hair cut. And then I'm going to see the next week or 2 weeks, so Matt O.B. in Mesa, Nevada.
What?
I think whoever that was emailing the wrong person.
God!
That's just what I think.
That went went nowhere.
What? I'm trying to figure out what the hell they're talking about.
That email had no rhyme or reason to it. Nothing. It had no reason, no rhyme.
Dude, I'm at a loss for words. I'm trying to figure out who in the bloody hell Tangerine and Bold you are. What the bloody hell is that? Like, where did I go wrong? What am I missing?
Exactly.
This is crazy, man. Like, really? This is what I get to come back to?
Something that long and that bad.
It was ridiculous. It had nothing to do with nothing. Anyway.
Wow.
All right. Brother Abdul Jason Mack and wow. Brother Erotic Eric Alexa Waheed. Now, look. I'm going to get into the email in a minute. I just want to say this. What are you thinking? Like, who are these people?
Exactly.
And where did they get the brother from? Like, what the hell is that? Man, anyway.
Brother Abdul Jason Mack?
Say what?
Are you kidding me? Brother Abdul Jason Mack, are you kidding me?
What is that? And Brother Erotic Eric Alexa Waheed. Anyway, brothers, I have a preposition for you all to end Greece. A what? Brothers, I have a preposition for you all to end Greece, our turning power. The venture requires and contestants from you brothers of the fine Nancy quality to fund us. Okay. We will be us letting the brothers to seesaw the wick ways of the brands, not us. Understand yet? No, I don't. Keep listening to the beat.
What beat?
The fine Nancy contrabandutions will fund us to educate the brothers. What? The turning power will end Greece brand presence. Brand presence equals X toes her for the show, all while splitting the light to the brothers to overthrow the brands, not us. See the plan in context, me. Brother Markel Abdul Rahim.
God, this is terrible. What in hell?
Dude, man. I don't even know what this guy's trying to say. Like, for real. What's the point of even emailing if you don't even have a point? Like, you don't have any subject matter or nothing. Just
random is for no reason.
Like, right. Like, there's supposed to be some secret matrix-like message behind this ridiculous garbage.
And like he's running some kind of scheme for sure.
It's something.
I don't know what the scheme is. I can't decode your scheme.
I don't know, man. I'm at a loss for words. I mean, none of this. What's the turning power? Because they keep talking about the damn turning power in the Greek. Like, what's that?
I think he means maybe increase, maybe, but he couldn't say the word right.
That dude said the turning power well in Greece.
And I think then, he meant increased brand presence. That's the things what he meant. Increased our turning power. I don't know what that even means.
He needs his ass whooped for that. And then he had a preposition for you all to increase our turning power.
Proposition, what? My man.
Yeah, but what's the turning power?
Yeah, I have no idea. How fast you turn the steering wheel to the car, how fast you turn the Ferris wheel, or the little spinny thing, or a go-kart. I don't know what he means.
That dude sounds crazy.
Keep listening to the beat. What beat, though?
I don't know where that came
from. The brand's not us. See the plan. What plan, my man?
For real. I mean, because that came out of way. That came way out of left field. Way. Oh my goodness. Anyway, we got another one coming up. This is horrible. Marks up Tim in election whack.
Oh God. What?
What?
God.
That's not even remotely similar to our name.
You got that right. You got that right.
That fool's been marked up, Tim.
Election wax.
That is ridiculous.
That's some wax you use to push the button at the polls? Like, what does that mean? Like,
I don't know what the hell that means, but if you... You should see it. Well, look, check this out. I be catering with my wifey. That fool said catering. Catering. I work in Creole steak.
Oh, God.
We sail house seas. What? Possum pissy pissu. Is that my wifey have gas?
Oh, God.
L day and L day just heat gas. How I tell her this ain't cold? What?
Guess it means cool, I guess.
Flip flipper in North Carolina. That he spelled North, N-O-R-F.
He's literate as hell. Obviously.
Yes. Yes, his parents are cousins. I guarantee.
Quartering, not quarantine, but quartering.
Quartering.
Two elves.
Let's do this, man. Leave that mess alone.
He said he works in real estate. How about real estate, my man? You can't spell your own job.
That fool said real estate. I work in Creole estate.
I think he spelled sale wrong as well.
I thought it was a restaurant at first. That's what I thought. I said Creole.
God.
That must be new.
Wow.
That must be like steak and shake. Anyway. Listener email. Derek and Justin, my damn female Quisha done made me mad. She has an idea for a family?
Any family, I guess.
How do you not know how to spell family? A family night show. I agree. Show is a karaoke night. I'm Leak Cool Broad. Show. She bring a karaoke machete. Show me my son and her can shame karaoke. Now, I don't know what Shane, is Shane karaoke different from, like, Martin karaoke?
Golly.
Maybe I just want to know. Okay. But the machete was sealed with Ray Roaches. With Ray Roaches. Not really. Anyway. Ray Roaches all over my house. My son cares. I ain't speak to her since then. what I need to do. Robert in Texas. Well,
oh,
let's
God.
Start off. Let's start off with Hooked on Phonics.
Oh God, female, that I spell female.
That dude has me thrown off. I'm looking at his stuff like, really?
An idea?
Unbelievable. Like, how drunk were you to write this email? You must have been seeing it in 3D.
Not a karaoke machine, but a karaoke machete. Not a machine, but a machete.
Right, a machete. He's going to be a whole DJing Jason. Unbelievable.
Okay. Call the working man. Do that. Call the working man. Call pest control.
He's done. He's some rage. Control.
That's what you do, my man.
Dude, like, what are you thinking? Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Dude, really? Majestic champion in season Hibbit.
Wow.
Yo, pump up the volume. It's me, DC from the DMV. Looky here, shoot, man. I be having side P-mails. Side
what?
Emails.
What?
Okay.
Is it me, females?
Side P-mails and stuff. With the virus, I can't go see my tricks. I like my mama of kids, but she be wildin', so I bailed her out with the other chicks. Okay? How I can get to my other legions with the virus? Mask or suit while sex? What day you? DC from the DMV, Chico of the Year. I tell you, that's amazing.
I'm worried about that P-mails part. I don't know if that, does he mean female or did he really mean P-mails?
Dude, I think he actually meant P-mails. That's what I think. That's just, anyway, Joe Hollywood and Alan Brooks. Any tips on hell to become school? My offering, my offspring. What the fuck? What is an offspring?
Is it mean offspring, maybe?
Man, dude, these cats need, man, these cats need riff or something. Anyway, I am of the alphabet mix.
What?
Right. I am of the alphabet mix. I just got an alphabet mix since I did not do high school original recipe.
What?
What? So there's that? With the alphabet number 19, I in aware of bucks, so I can get bucks to help my offspring with homeschool.
He meant bookstore, bro. He meant bookstore, bro. He meant bookstore. He meant bookstore.
I'm out of there. Hell me, no, yeah.
What? Wow. My God.
That fool said, hell me, no, yeah. Okay. That was EJ in South Carolina. More like ENJ. And a lot of, that's kind of what that's like. Okay. Junction Hill. Junction Hill. Junction Hill in Magic Orlando.
Oh my God.
It's only getting worse. Gentlemen, I need a break from my house. These kids and mama of them annoying. Of the four kids here, only of them is mine by her. The daddy won't take his kids in for break since he got a new woman. So his bad kids is tearing up my damn house. Mama won't say nothing to them. This arrangement is bugging me now. I like being in with my dad, but the other three being and downing my cash I got is maddening. Maddening. So why should I do? I need help. Robinson in Michigan. Well, you want to know what? First of all, you do need help. But it's not the type of help you think you need. Okay, the type of help that you need is you need to get your behind in your car and go find the nearest psychiatrist. That's what you ought to do. Because this is crazy. Like, what are they doing? Here we got another one. Boss Million in Gale Hollywood.
What?
Gael. Sounds like something from the Hebrew Israelites.
Oh my God.
Boss Million in Gael Hollywood. I haven't been seeing my chick. She's been acting real reckless with this COVID-19 mess. I mean, she's going to sit back, low-key basement parties, having her hair done at home, having her nails done at home, and not wearing a mask in public. She being extra reckless, bro-gram. He just called us bro-gram.
Oh, wow. Bro-gram? I think he is.
That's different. I ain't trying to take an L because her ass is reckless. I absolutely care a lot for her. I absolutely care a lot for her, but her behavior with this virus has made me look at her in different light. I don't know how we proceed with her being this reckless and not respecting the virus. Any tips? Yes, get the hell out of the house while you can.
Mm-hmm.
Because it seems like if she's not taking it serious, ain't no telling what kind of trouble she can get you into. Because you don't know really where she's really been unless she's told you, apparently.
Wow.
Yeah, that was Bruce in Birmingham. Yeah, he kind of has a real problem right there. You know, I don't know. You know, now it's not the time to be acting reckless, you know what I'm saying? When you're trying to feel out, you got to watch out for another MF. Like, really?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure dating right now is hard because, you know, some people are conspiracy theorists. Some people still believe it ain't that bad. Some people believe black people can't get the virus still. So, you know, we got these fools out here who believe different things, right?
Of course.
So Bruce's girls might be one of them people, and he's trying to be safe because he's tripping.
Well, I dig. But that doesn't make the email any less jacked up.
Correct. Programs.
Yeah, that was.
And the names.
That was over the top. Okay, this ought to be good. Let me see. Boss in Hollywood. All right, here we go. Boss in Hollywood, can you all help me get my stimulus check?
Stimulus. Oh, God.
They got it spelled STEMALYS. He needs a literacy check. I need my Texas feel. Not taxes, the state, Texas. Can the show do it for me? It's me and my four sons. They mama in jail. G-E-L. Right, right. I need the paper. I work at Crystal. Did they have more stimulus checks? If so, what types? What types? Is Maurice Morris in Atlanta? There's too many things wrong with this picture right here. Too many. I work at Crystal. Man, them burgers, man. Something about them Crystal burgers. But anyway. All right. Patrick and Jonathan. Man, what is going on? Patrick and Jonathan. Since the virus demic, this chick I be rocking with done got fatter. She's eating like crazy. Other Ubarians? Really? Ubarians? At least othering who? This is crazy. At least four times a day. If I don't finish my food, she trying to eat mine. Forget a leftover. She in that fridge cowing down.
Damn.
Excuse me. She done gained 36 pounds in the virus demic. 208 pounds, 244. Is getting out of control. Why is she eating so much? How do I stop her? My budget and my account is being ate away, literally and figuratively, physically. What it is, Chris in New Orleans. Man, it looks like you need to put a lock on a friend, dude.
Most definitely.
And she might kill him for it, but, you know, it's an effort that counts, right? To have your wife kill you over a sandwich. Unbelievable. All right. Here's another fantastic email. Nun Jeff and Jail Kelly, can the show provide me a down payment on a car? Can the show provide me a down payment on a car? They got the virus. They got virus sales at the car lot. What? Yes, no, maybe. I need a new car, bros. Help, Dante in Arizona. Dude, what are you talking about? And what's a virus sale? Is that like a contaminated thing that they put on a boat? Man, like, how do you expect us to give you any help if you can't even articulate what you're supposed to be trying to say? Instead, you're speaking like it's third-grade rhetoric or something. Dude, man, these emails were always tough to read.
You're getting worse from the quarantine, obviously.
And that was it.
I'll send you some more.
Okay, I see. Okay, yes, gotcha.
I'm going through as we speak.
Robert Alerkin and Purified Savage. Purified Savage? Dude, come on. Yo, Mayor. What? I need a new car today. All along with a Lowe's coupon kiosk. Really? Really? My broad wants to do a child picture shoot. I do not agree. I don't most definitely catch the COVID 19.
Oh my God.
Dude, that was rough. that weirded me out. Anyway, bro, got another listener email. Bassett,
wow.
Bassett and Helium. Helium.
No. Yeah.
Dude. So I'm going to need some help. My state is trying to open. I don't know. Land could open.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God. I didn't know man's land was a business. I don't understand how land can close. Did I miss something? Jazz the man in the rock.
Oh, my God.
Dude. What is going on here?
These guys are getting worse.
And who's the jazz the man in jazz? The what rock? What the hell kind of rock? What?
Is it me, Little Rock,
Little
baby?
Little Rock, Arkansas. Okay. Gotcha. All right. Waterman and Value Gary. I'm so discouraged right now because, like, I'm just trying to wait for the time that, like, our names, like, really pop up without any tweaking and twerking done to it. And how many years I've been doing this, and people, the same people listening to us and following us, we've been doing this for years. And never have I ever. Oh my God. Jazz the man. Okay. Okay. Waterman and Value Gary. I don't a money center. This is crazy. I don't a money center. I want a check from the Congress.
Oh, God.
I don't a have sex none money. This is insane. Do I need to acquire a shoe one? I wink and work for cashing. Food is underground. Food is underground from you, Barrett.
You miss Uber Eats, bro.
I'm done.
Uber Eats.
That's what it is. Uber. Oh my God. Trade me for the check. Earl in San Antonio. That's the only thing that was right. The whole thing was just.
We're not the government, Earl.
This dude is crazy.
We can't help you, Earl.
Earl in San Antonio. Man, and you figure how nice San Antonio is. You just figure yourself that some of the people out there are smart or something. Guess not. Okay. Here we go. Dental appointment and chat support. Where I get masks. I don't want to pay $95 for a mask. $95 what? Because one is one figure is absolutely reasonable and one ain't. You understand what I'm saying? So yes. I ain't in sure. What the hell? Sure-ger him me? What?
What?
It said, I ain't in sure-ger have me. Have mine. I don't miss clothes mask. What I wear a mask for? Any word? Kilohertz. J loves to. Man, this whole thing is messed up. It's just a podge of words. It doesn't even make any logical sense, dude. Like, I'm exasperated already.
Where's his name at, though?
dude is ridiculous. Like, what? I mean, guys, people actually sit at their freaking computer desk and they just get their fingers to move and don't even care to proofread what they wrote. Take out what they like and what they don't like. I mean, come on, man. This is stupid, man. I thought this was going to be a good one, but I'm wrong. Anyway, Boss in Hillbilly Hollywood. My chick still wants to go vacation even though the pandemic is hitting tough. She told me to look at some destinations on the airplane site to find cheap hotels. Dude, hotels, H-O-E-tels, and fly kites. What? I'm not feeling tilted. I'm not feeling this. Whatever. This is a serial loud loop situation. Dude. Where am I? This is serial. What? This is a serial lust, a serial loud lust situation. You know what I mean. It's a pandemic. I ain't trying to vacation nowhere but being her legs and mine.
What?
You feel me? I tiding think of her on two occasions. That's day band in night. Dude, I'm done.
Oh, guys, are you deal now?
And then he's gonna quote right, and he's quoting the fucking deal.
Oh, God! He's quoting deal.
Dude, like I tripped out so hard, like I dropped my mirror. Like, seriously.
Oh, God. His point deal in the middle of an email is terrible. Oh, my God.
Of all the things he could have. Dude, that's just stupid. It's just the dumbest thing.
Oh, God.
That's some stuff that Rob would have said.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. That's some stuff that Rob would have said straight up. Okay, I want to tell her to chill on this idea of a chic pandemic vacation. Give me some knob pledge. Ricky Sims in Chicago, and that sounds about right. That was horrible. He wants a sheep pandemic vacation. Okay. George and Keith. PPE. PPE. Test. Tests are a hard. I got a geed. Tracing. What? X paint to me. Hand tank. Tracy in Louisville. Don't ever email us again.
Please. Ever.
I don't even know what that says. Like, what were they alluding to? I don't know either, bro. Okay, Boston Hollywood, I miss you all. I'm sorry for the dummies. I'm not one. Alicia and Philly. No, you're not. You are absolutely not a dummy. You are on the FUI list, but you're definitely not a dummy. And I can tell because I read your email with absolutely no problem whatsoever. Even though it was short. That works better for me. All right. Reed and Cliff. Back to what it was. VisionWorks said they can trick my eyes right. Two come in for eye exam. I'm scared of an eye exam. Whole day exam made safe. You can so-called dictate. What? You can so-called dictate in eye exam.
What?
Shoulder I go or I sip. Dow or jet up. Brian in Southern Indiana. I mean, what do you want? I mean, what do you want us to tell you? He's talking about his eye. He had an eye exam. Well, Muff, I mean, did you go? If that's what you're talking about, because, I mean, I don't know why you would even include that in your email. Anyway. All right. Boss in Hollywood. My job is done. I work in store. Store is closes. I have no money. Can you cash at me? Thanks. Chrissy in Atlanta. Well, Chrissy in Atlanta, I got one answer for you. And that's
hell
a
no.
Grand, old-fashioned hell no. You don't get one quarter. You don't get any lint in the pot. You get nothing. Absolutely nothing. Oh, gosh. Boy, that's tiring. All right, listener email. Clint Mack in Balk Alec. Do you have masks for sale? I need a mask. My broad said you got any work. Travis in Idaho. Travis in Idaho in Eyes of Pimp. That might have went over y'all head. So you said Travis in Idaho. And I also said Eyes of Pimp. All right. Anyway, true to life, my wife does make masks. And maybe she'll think about selling. So, leave an address or whatever. Knowing wow. you, knowing them, you know what I'm saying? They'll leave on the day it's supposed to be delivered.
Exactly.
We're out of town. I mean, we're not coming back. Unbelievable. All right. Great in Apple Holland. Jordan's on sale today. Should I go use my unemployment for it or what? I watched the Dick Metron. What? Yo, fuck it. Give me the damn call money. Petite Late. I don't even know what that is. And I don't wear Jordan. You know what I'm saying? Like, I wear Chuck Taylor. If anything, I just like to shoot. You know, if I see a nice pair of Jordans, I'll probably get some. But they're probably older school, like, you know what I mean? Not these Jumpman things. I can't hang. You know what I'm saying? But I don't know why you're telling me Jordans are on sale.
Yeah.
I just don't know. Don't know why. Don't want to know why. You know what I'm saying? But it's all good. Okay.
God, this is guys is terrible.
These are horrible.
It literally has finest. These are fresh. I'm getting them out the email about to speak.
Dude, these are horrible. Right? Listener email. All right, check it out. Kevin and Ramon. Bossy called me for a lip service session. All right. Told me if she sucked me up, I get pole motion. Oh, gotcha. Set up or not? I fims you do want to smish her, but she offering ring lip. What? What it do? Corey and Arnie? I mean, it was decent up until the last couple of sentences. Then he just went full, I got a stroke. Bossy called me for a lip service. Oh, dude, man, well, if she's willing to give you a promotion, man, you got to go for it. Especially if she's giving you some dynamite, you know, Mugambo. She's giving you that skull bone. Know what I'm saying? Corey and Arnie, I don't know where the hell that is or what the hell that is. But shoot. We got some more?
Oh, yeah. It's coming right to you now.
All right.
Wow, this email is terrible.
That last one was... I mean, what do you think?
God.
Freshman.
My man should... It's a setup.
Huh?
It's a setup. The other one's a setup.
Yeah.
That one for a setup. She's trying to get you fired.
Oh, yeah, bro. She's going to have all that good, juicy information. She's going to be snitching first thing in the morning. Before your coffee even get hot. Okay. Freshman Freddy and Eric Alik. I just got a side chick pregnant. My money low due to virus. The other day, got in... What? A Mayud? A Mayud?
IUD, probably.
IUD. What? Oh, my God. So what I need to run, I want to my 3 Pergurant. Pergurant? Hey, help your boy. Mary Marco. I have no words.
Mm-hmm.
You got a side chick Pergurant. So what I need to run, I want to my 3 Pergurant.
Wow.
Help your boy. Man, you need all the help you get, player. Especially with English.
Yeah.
Yeah, because, whatever he said, that's just not working, bro.
Man.
It's not working.
God, this is hard.
Very. Like, this is some of the most discouraging shit.
Oh, my God.
All right, man. Unbelievable. John and Harold. Look, Tibbs, big bitch, got me fired because I quit taking to her after she did no more sex. I just started to talk her.
What?
I don't harass her. Just hip-tarting Adam, check request. That must be special code. I need a job. I do anything, right? That sounds like my crackhead uncle putting in a listing for a job. Like after filling out an application or something. Ray. And his name is Ray. And it's my Uncle Ray. Isn't that unbelievable? Like, he sounds like a notorious crackhead, and my Uncle Ray is a notorious crackhead.
That's too coincidental right there.
Yeah, bro. I'm trying to tell you. Okay. I got it. I don't have insurance. Wow. Just the show offer insurance. I have to go to doctor. I will pay premium water. Right. Tacos are well, Carlos. Yeah, them tacos had mushrooms in them or something. Magic mushrooms. There's something wrong with that dude's head, I'm trying to tell you.
Mm-hmm.
Doggone Carlos. Absolutely ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
And the tacos are well. I didn't know the tacos were sick. All right.
Mm-hmm. Got a few more to go. Like, for real.
Dude, these emails, man, are out of pocket.
Mm-mm. Some of the worst ever.
It's on another level. Like, I'm...
Oh, God.
Yeah, dude, I'm on another planet right now. Now, check this out. Coriander and Dorian. Is it safe to rerun to work? No, it's not safe to rerun Roger or Dwayne to work. The virus is still here. So apparently the virus has made you deaf. Without telling you. The state is Ipenix.
Wow.
Ipenix. Okay.
Wow.
I lose fee money. I need it. I need to save. Okay, and what's stopping it?
Exactly.
If he needs to save, like, what's stopping him from saving?
Oh, God. These guys are the worst.
Well, I was just trying to figure it out.
Oh, my God.
And then he calls himself Poppy.
He must be some kind of a street carny hustler or something.
I don't know, but that's the answer right there.
Wow.
It's all in the name.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow. In our last 5 minutes, bro, let's recap. I mean, I'm still tripping off my man who quoted two occasions by the deal.
Dude, that threw me all the way off. Like, you really...
And all you're mad that you quoted the deal.
I mean, he really said that. I mean, and he... Let's keep it trilling. He sounded like a true-to-life sucker. I mean, you know what I'm saying?
Like Ron Zombie.
Right. Like, I remember when I was in school and that song came out, you find a lot of the geeks who are singing it, you understand, and they usually weren't getting picked by any girls either. You know what I'm saying? A lot of times we had these guys, they wanted to be a bootleg R&B group, thinking that it'd get them some notoriety, you know what I'm saying, by singing that particular song from the deal, and it never, I mean, it got them a pat on the head, but, no, I mean, not much else.
Yeah, like, it's a good song, but, yeah, it can get very suckerish real fast.
Very. Like, you know, it's just, it's dope and it's a classic, but it's simpish.
Yeah.
You know.
Like, yeah. Like, you know, if you want some songs to sing to a chick, like, I mean, just off top of my head, thinking about it off top of my head, you know, like, okay, let's real fast pull up a list here of songs you can send to a chick that, you know, hey, how about this? Puff Daddy, Satisfy You, Luther, In Your Lovely Wrong, I don't Want to Be Right, Frankie Beverly, We Are One, Surface, Closer Than Friends, Zeppelin Rouse, I Want to Be Your Man, Let Me Love You by Mario, High Five, well, that can be kind of suckerish too. I like your way to Kissing Game, that can be suckerish. High Five, Quality Time, This Edwards, Don't Look Any Further.
Right.
Rock Steady, maybe. Ready for the World, Love You Down.
Oh, my God.
I'll be sure the deal is kind of same thing. Night and day, day and night, two occasions, same thing. They're both suckerish. That's the two of us by Bill Withers, okay? SOS Band, no one's gonna love you. Okay, maybe not so suckerish. It's on something for the people, all I do. So for real, everything I do, you on my mind, you on my mind, you on my mind. Yeah, maybe, I don't know. As well as for the love of you, maybe not so suckerish. Yeah, D'Angelo Lady, DeBarge, all this love.
Oh my God.
Cisco Incomplete. Gap Band, you're yearning for your love, maybe.
Oh, yearning for your love is like the simp anthem of the last like 3 decades.
So there's some songs he could have went with, but he chose to go with the deal. On 2 occasions, that's day and night.
Unbelievable.
He goes for broke. Oh my God. Oh. That's gonna be the height of the show. He went with deal.
Of all the things he could have picked.
Yeah. Oh my God!
I bet you wear an ascot. Ain't nobody. Can't nobody tell me nothing.
Has an umbrella too.
With a right. In a London fall. Wow. With some sandals.
Bro, that's gonna stick with me forever. He quoted deal in another bad email.
Oh my God.
So bro, before we go, what is your thoughts on tonight's quarantine special, man?
Oh man, I enjoyed it for one, you know, and I just hope that they enjoyed it too. Because the bottom line is we're in this, we truly are in this together. And we're gonna have to help each other out. I mean, whatever it takes to make sure that we get back to the way it was. And, you know, I, for one, that's what I'm longing for. So that's what I'm hoping for. Hey.
And they begged for this show. We gave them what they wanted. Entertainment. We gave them a classic moment on the show.
Right.
My man quoting the deal 2 occasions in the middle of a bad email.
That was unfreaking believable.
That's going to go in the show archives forever. Like,
oh, God, yeah.
Quarantine special when my man quoted deal. Like, for real.
He tried to put it in there on a slick. Like, I was like, it was almost as if I was going to read through it.
You're like, hold on. That's the deal.
Hey, man, hold up. I know that song. That's a pretty good song.
Oh, my God. Thank you so much, FUIs. What a great job, FUIs. So, we hope you enjoyed the show. Did it for you guys. Thank you again for supporting us. And we will try to help you out whenever we can. Hope this tides you over for a while to the show. 2 hours of fun. So for Boss, Hollywood, FUIs, everybody, be safe.
Yeah.
Don't take any fool chances. It's not worth your life.
That's right.
Folks, we are out.
Peace.
And if you don't know, now you know, you know. My heart skips skipping a beat, you're not close enough, so that space between you and me, let's lose it. The way you're dancing, swaying to the music, girl, that body and how you move it. Every time you cross my mind, girl, I lose it.
Alexa, play the Country Heat playlist.
Okay.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
It's maybe the night that my dreams might let me know. All the stars are closer. All the stars are closer.
Tell me what you gonna do to me. Confrontation ain't nothing new to me. You could bring a bullet, bring a sword, bring a morgue, but you can't bring the truth to me.
Alexa, play Kendrick Lamar and SZA.
Okay.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
Till the tears run down from my eyes, Lord, somebody, ooh, somebody, can anybody find me somebody to love?
Alexa, play hits from Queen.
Okay.
Somebody to love. With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.